now?
Oh, this is my plasma cutter. I was going to make a little cut, but the tip is worn out on it, so I got to change tip. Hey, come here, check it out. So you see, this is the torch, and the little tip is in here. This is called a swirl ring. The tip goes down into the electrode and the nozzle go inside this. When the air comes up through the torch head, or torch handle, it swirls through here. Comes out past the electrode in a swirl into the nozzle, swirling. And then there's an electrical arc that cuts across from the electrode to the nozzle, and that's where the plasma is developed. That's what actually makes it. See how burned up this is?
Well, show me a new one in comparison.
See the difference?
Oh, yeah.
This is the old one. You see a big pit right in the middle of it. This is the new one, and it's flat all the way across, nice and smooth. On the nozzle, you can see all the burning around the edge. Hole's a little elongated. This on the new one, the hole is nice and clean and smooth and perfect right in the middle. All right, let me show you the difference in the cuts. Let me put the old one back in. Fire it up for just a second and make a little cut, and I'll show you the difference. See, that's the cut with the old nozzle and electrode in it. And you can see how wide they are. So we'll change these out. Put a new nozzle, a new electrode. And that's the only change we're going to make. You can see there's a little difference in the kerf on the cut. With the new nozzle, it's a little tighter, it's a little smaller. A little cleaner on the backside, a little less draws coming off of it. Anytime you want to do any, you know, really precision work, you want to, or you're just getting started again, get out of there. Anytime you want to come in and do really tiny work, you know, put a new tip in it. Make sure your voltage is set right. Make sure your air pressure is set right. Makes it work a whole lot better. See you next time.